Hello again, everyone. It is 8:55 and 80 degrees. A lot of blue sky out there, Marty.
A lot of blue sky. We haven't seen that much blue sky in a long time.
Yeah.
It's going to be with us through the day, some passing fair weather shade clouds. Tonight, though, we'll get rain. But today, calm, hot and humid, 90 is a high. Christy, let's wrap it up. Take it away.
Well, good morning, Marty. Good morning, everyone. The Beltway, pretty slow go there on the top side, outer loop from Bel Air Road, just past Delaney Valley. You can see Cromwell Bridge Road kind of moving at a pace that we don't particularly like to see. Now moving over to some of the problems that we have, northbound 95 at White Marsh Boulevard, a vehicle fire there. Then we jump over to northbound 95 at Russell Street. That takes us to 32 westbound between Burns Crossing and Telegraph Road, and police activity on the outer loop at Liberty Road. Tim?
Christy, thank you. Maryland will mandate all hospital and nursing home staff get vaccinated by September 1st or face regular testing. Governor Hogan made the announcement during a news conference yesterday at the State House. The governor says he will increase fines and other penalties for nursing homes that fail to report vaccination data. In Baltimore City, Mayor Brandon Scott will give an update on the COVID status later this morning. Garth Brooks decides to cancel the next five stops of his nationwide tour because of the COVID virus. Now, that includes M&T Bank Stadium as well, which was scheduled for October 2nd. Ticket holders will get an automatic refund. Brooks says he hopes to resume the schedule again before the end of the year. Mari is up next. We'll see you at noon.